Finding the aircraft is just the beginning.
For the investigator, first thing to do is get back those recorders, because especially an airplane like a 777, there's a huge amount of data in the flight data recorder and the cockpit voice recorder. Get those back, and then we can see what we need to do next. But, you know, time is of the essence.
Tom Houter knows. He investigated the crash of TWA Flight 800, which exploded 12 and a half minutes after takeoff from New York's JFK Airport. His job began at the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean. U.S. Navy and other divers spent more than 1,600 hours scouring for clues.
In TWA 800, we found pieces from just forward of the center section of the wing. Then we found the nose of the aircraft, and then we found the wings and the tail and the engines and everything else further down the flight path.
Investigators believe that the breakup began with an explosion of the plane's center wing fuel tank, likely from a short circuit. The aircraft broke apart, erupting into a fireball before plunging into the ocean. The evidence was pieced together from a debris field of 75 square miles, thousands of fragments tangled among a web of wires and airplane skin.
We map the bottom, you start recovering things. You get back seat cushions, victim remains, and what you do is x-ray everything. Because you're looking for an explosion, you're looking for fast particles that may have been captured by a seat cushion or a body.
Among the debris, evidence of the 230 people lost on board. As painful as it is to think about, Houter says that recovered bodies can provide critical clues about a flight's final moments.
You take a look at all the information. Is there burning on the bodies beforehand? We'll get autopsies. There's a soot in the trachea showing that there was a fire on board.
Lifting the wreckage out of the water and reconstructing it was critical to debunking various conspiracy theories. Many witnesses of the crash reported seeing a streak of light in the air before the plane went down, fueling theories that the aircraft was taken down by a missile. Houter says that piecing the Boeing 747 together was necessary to get the full picture.
Like, you notice this door is badly burned, but the structure around it is absolutely unscathed. We take a look at everything we have here, and what we couldn't find anywhere in TWA was any evidence of being hit from a missile from the outside.